Hi everyone, and I hope you had a lovely day. It should be Boxing Day today for most of you. I'm actually filming this at the end of Christmas Day, so I hope you all had a lovely day of Christmas Day and you've enjoyed it with your rats as well. So today's 12 days of enrichment feeding. So today's is a fairly simple one and something that you can make use of what you should have lots of left over from Christmas. So I'm talking about wrapping paper. So we're going to do what's a fairly simple make and do, and actually one that you can do all through the year. You don't have to use wrapping paper if you don't have any, something like any kind of non-toxic paper. So in the UK, all newspapers safe to use. Check if you're in another country. Brown paper, any kind of wrapping paper. Kitchen towels works quite well as well. And what you will also need, toilet roll tubes. So we're going to be making rat Christmas crackers, and they're a really good way of getting the rats to work a little bit harder. So what we're going to do is we're going to stuff these tubes. So let's start with one of them. We're going to stuff them with a mixture of, I'm going to use some hay. So this is really nice quality hay. I use a brand called Dust Free Hay. It just got on very well with it. A lot of people think hay is problematic for rats. I think there's rumours around mites and lice and such. You do have to get a decent quality hay. You have to make sure it is good quality, dust free, but it's actually fine for rats, and actually all it is a bit of fibre, and in this case it's just very handy for holding stuff inside the crackers, and meaning that, because they don't really eat hay, they might nibble the odd bit of straw, but they don't eat it, they're not kind of set up for it digestively, but it adds a bit of enrichment for them, so they have to kind of forage for the food inside the hay. So I've just stuffed a little bit of hay in, and then I've got assorted bits and pieces. So we've got a liver brownie, which is a dog treat. That's a real treat for them, they'll quite like that. Liver's great because it's high in copper, so it's kind of a win-win for me. I've got a couple nuts in shells. These are kind of great for them because they have to chew into them as well. We're also going to stick in, assuming that I can get it in without losing the whole thing, so this might be a little bit more useful. A little bit of dry mix. You saw yesterday, if you watched the scatter feeding episode, just how much they like the dry mix. They do go mad for it. And a few assorted treats. I use training treats, so things like these are little kind of chickeny bits. There's almond flakes. Yeah, a little bit of mealworm there as well as an almond flake. But they're all treats that they quite like, get on very well with. And oh yes, let's give them a little bit of millet as well. I've got a spray millet here, so I'm just going to tear a few bits off and add that in. So all it is it's kind of a big, nice packed tube full. And then it's a very, very simple case of, sorry, not the best angle for this, just rolling up in wrapping paper. So very simple. Remember, the rats don't care if it's not perfectly neat. You may care more than them, but they really won't. So we're just twisting each end. And what I do as well, just to make it a little bit more secure, I've got some kind of, at least a little natural fibres you can get for helping potting plants. I think it adds a little bit to the look, and it'll also mean I can hang it up. As you can see, one side, they're just kind of made of straw, I think. But they're really quite useful for this kind of thing. I like to hang this kind of stuff up in the cage because the girls are quite, I would say, advanced at enrichment feeding. They've had it their full lives. So what I'll do is I'll stick another bit around the middle, and I will hang this up in the cage, and I'll video it later to see how they get on. Can't give them too much food at the moment because Mog is hopefully pregnant. So we have a nice little hanging cracker. So I'm going to quickly make another one because I've got some girls staying over at the moment, so I want them to not feel left out as well. Similar principle, bit of hay. I'll stick that brownie at one end because that was nice and solid, stop all the rust falling out. A couple more nuts and shells, a little bit more dry mix, assorted treats, and let's stick some millet in. Oops. a bit when you've got slightly too much millet. So luckily you can't see my knee at the moment, it's absolutely covered in bits of seed and such. Fold it all in. And we'll roll it back up again. Quick as that, we have another cracker. It is a really nice kind of simple little treat you can do for them. Not only does it look good, but they really enjoy it, and once they've figured it out, they'll be tearing into the paper very, very quickly. Right. And you'll have great fun watching them as well. They're also quite nice to put under the tree. If it wasn't already past Christmas. So there we are, we have our two crackers. So I'm going to stop this video for now and then we'll go and stick it in the rat cage and see what they make of it. So the cracker's in, and you can see straight away they know there's something going on. Whether it's because, rescue a rat. Are you missing the food here? Whether it's because they can smell the food in it or they're used to me offering them things. See, what's this? Go on. They also know that they can potentially get out of the cage, which makes the cracker slightly less interesting. So let's try shutting this. Go on, heads in. Yes, your head too, potato. Go on. We can see. In fact, let me remove the bottle for now. Ellie seems to have got the knack of it. And Mog is now figuring out that the rope that I've attached it to, she may chew through that. It is very chewable. Oh, we definitely have interest now. Mog, in her somewhat hungry state, has realised that she can get into there. I'll try opening it again, there might be more. That's a slightly better view. Oh, and they've got it down. Success! Now you have to get into it, girls. Now I can see you, Taker. And now the great butchery begins. Go on, you've got loads of food in there. There is frenzied tearing going on now. I'll try moving you a bit closer. Drop it down. They're running away. Come on. If I hadn't have tied the ends, they'd have been in this a lot faster. Oh, oh, we have hit. There is definitely some happy rats. And the silence and peace descends as they all break into the food. You can see it's quite a simple, but it's a very effective treat, and they do really enjoy it. And they will be chewing on the stuff in there for a little while yet. So I'll leave them to it, and then hopefully you'll have a go at making them for you yourself and your own rats.